Democrat Gladys Robinson, Republican Trudy Wade, and unaffiliated candidate Bruce Davis.
Bill O'Neill joins us now in our studios with more on that story. Bill?
Guys, Democrat Katie Dorsett seemingly tried to pick her own successor in this race when she pulled out at the very last minute. But what should have been a slam dunk for Democrats is now a three-way fight.
Republican Trudy Wade says as a fiscal conservative, she's the candidate of change in this race.
I think if you vote for my two opponents, you're just staying with the status quo and going to get more of the same.
Democrat Gladys Robinson says it would be a terrible loss if Republicans were to win this seat.
This seat specifically was designed to make sure that people who are not served well are served.
Bruce Davis is the wild card in the race. Normally a Democrat, he's running as an unaffiliated candidate. He says High Point needs to have its own senator.
If your representative is not at the table who understands the issues and live within that area, then it becomes a second thought.
Davis, a Navy veteran and small business owner, says his experience as chairman of the Guilford County Commissioners makes him uniquely qualified for the job. When asked how he would deal with the anticipated budget shortfall of $3 billion or more, Davis says he'd support spending cuts, such as furloughs for state workers, over raising taxes.
I favor the possibility of voting for a tax increase.
I don't see me voting for a tax increase. No.
I'm the better candidate because
Gladys Robinson, who sits on the UNC Board of Governors, says she's protective of education and would favor taxing services to help make up for the budget shortfall.
We know that there are some services that are not taxed. So we've got to really do, and I'm sure we're going to start doing that right away in terms of looking at the tax structure, who's not paying taxes, who's overpaying taxes, et cetera.
Trudy Wade, former Guilford County Commissioner and currently a member of the Greensboro City Council, says raising taxes is not the answer.
If you're not going to raise taxes to make up that shortfall, then tell us where you would look at cutting some of that spending.
I think we need to look at everything, and I think we need to look at maybe privatizing some areas, such as the crime lab. That'd be first on my list.
How these three candidates came to run for the seat is one of the better political stories of the year. Robinson, who has never run for political office, filed on the final day of registration, the same day incumbent Katie Dorsett pulled out of the race. Wade says she had no plans to run until her campaign manager called her the night before with the news that Dorsett was pulling out of the race.
He had heard that rumor. I think someone had called and asked him to work on Gladys's campaign, to be exact.
Bruce Davis says he didn't file for the race because he didn't know Dorsett was pulling out. Instead, he and his supporters had to collect more than 5,000 signatures just to get his name on the ballot. Now this lifelong Democrat has to convince Democrats not to vote the straight party ticket.
My biggest concern, again, is the straight ticket.
And the 28th Senate District runs from the Randolph County border up to the Huffine Mill Road, and it's bordered by Skeet Club Road on the west and McConnell Road on the east. This is a very strong Democratic district with Democrats outnumbering Republicans by 2-1. It also has more African-American voters than white voters. Guys?